City Hall, we're doing this thing and stuff. Although Lieutenant Governor Ponte is the younger one on the team, but he has some contact. There's this rule that we can't both be on the same vessels when we travel. And so he called earlier and said, you know, we can't travel, as you know, together, so why don't you go up on the 8 o'clock boat and I'll go up on the 9? And so I wanted to thank him so much for his graciousness and consideration. But he will be up on the 9, and then I'm going to go down on the 10 so he can go down on the 11. So in the end, I would. It's really been a lot of fun. We're really enjoying ourselves, and we thank the inaugural committee and all of the volunteers for their hard work that each of you have done in making all of these events memorable, enjoyable, and pleasant. And I just look forward tonight, and I'll just tell you how we've been handling the balls, and as Willie will tell you, I think we got in trouble with one of them because they had a whole program set up and we didn't really recognize it. We saw all the folks. And we just bust through the doors and went, started going from table to table and taking pictures, and then we were on the dance floor, and we were out the door in the car into the next ball, and they were with all the gifts and everything. And what happened to these people? So they have us under more control, and that's better. But it's really been wonderful, and I'm going to take the opportunity. And did I see lobster on somebody's plate? Government gave us $100,000 for these balls, and you know, we had put out a call for to raise money for the balls, and we owe a debt of gratitude to Mr. Sebastiano Paiwanski, the fundraising chair of our inaugural committee, because we raised the money. And Ms. Louie, if I'm correct, we had 2, 5, 7 balls in the territory. 3 St. Croix, 2 St. Thomas, 2, 1 St. Thomas, so 6 balls. So, and then all of the other costs with it. So the community really came out in a very big way, and because of the efforts of Mr. Paiwanski, we really were able to pull this off and pull this together. And I don't know if I should say this just yet, but they're allowed to veto me. I don't think we're going to even use all of the $100,000 that the government is setting aside. So we can pull that out. But that's because of the support that each and every one of you have given to these festivities and coming and purchasing the tickets and being there in the room is just completely filled, and I'm very heartened by that. So I just want to thank you all. I know that Lapsay no good when I get cold, so I'm not going to stay here talking all night. And I'm going to take the opportunity. Do I get a lobster? Or? I'm going to have me on a very strict diet. Curry, lettuce, and baked tomato. I don't know if it's working well, but I'm going to enjoy it. But so I'm going to come out tonight and just walk among and just greet everyone and say hello, and I just have a good time with you, and for all of you beautiful ladies that would like to help me raise my reputation and my character, please take a picture with me. The hard-nosed man, then you just enjoy the one that your wives are going to take. And I'm going to come and just come and socialize and just have a good time and express our thanks and our gratitude. And when the Lieutenant Governor comes, I'm going to ask you to give him the opportunity to say a few words, okay? So thank you. Enjoy your meal, Laurel. My cousin, Mrs. Seward. Ah, you're right there in front of me. You're so beautiful. You know, Laurel, we're all broken right there together. I'm not going to put your business in the street. Everybody knows we come from a large family. And Uncle Siva, which is Laurel's father, and Shelbourne, and Deli. And am I missing anyone? That's the 3 Siva kids, right? Uncle Siva had the reputation in the family for giving grouches. You know, you put you in a place with a good grouch. And that will tell them why, Laurel. But Lauren still holds the title and the mantle for getting the worst brown chicken I've ever had. Obviously, you and your committee did an excellent job, and husband and I thank you very much, and thank your committee very much, and for the wonderful job that you did, and the beauty, and the class, and the dignity that you and Miss Louie brought that touch of elegance to this inauguration. And, you know, maybe I shouldn't be saying this, but Osmond and I, as you can see, we're kind of single guys. And to pull off events with this dignity and graciousness and class is wonderful. We had nothing to do with it other than to ask, where's the cold beer? But thank you so much. Have a wonderful evening, and I'm coming down to socialize with you.